Hey everyone, welcome to Lowdown, your source for music, arts, and entertainment from the Akron area and beyond.
We've got a great episode coming up today, and some of our content is really different.
In this episode, we're taking a look into audience feedback, a play, and some solo artists.
So stick around, because this episode of Lowdown starts now.
Hey everyone, for the start of this episode of Lowdown, instead of interviewing a band or music artist, we decided to take a twist and interview the fans in line for the music artist. I interviewed fans in Pittsburgh that were waiting in line for Jake Miller and Hoodie Allen on the Whatever USA tour. There were over 500 people at this show. Why was this concert so popular? Well, here's what the fans had to say. What's up? It's Sophia with Lowdown, and today we are in Pittsburgh, PA, doing a fan on the street interview with fans in line for the Hoodie Allen and Jake Miller Whatever USA tour. Let's check it out. How long have you been a fan of Jake's, and how long have you been in line?
I've been in line since 10 o'clock this morning, so long time.
I have been in line for like an hour and a half, and I've been a fan of Jake's since 2013. Since I was a junior in high school, so 5 years ago?
Five or six years ago, I saw him on YouTube with A Million Lives and like kind of fell in love with the song and thought he was pretty cute.
What's your favorite song that Jake's gonna perform tonight?
Could Have Been You.
Oh, why?
I don't know, I like the beat of it, and I like that he talks about LA and like how it changed, like supposedly changed like the girl, and like he's changed for the better.
Lionheart.
Why?
That song bops.
All of them. Because I don't know the set list. The best song to see him perform is Collide.
Why?
Because that one goes hard.
Are you excited for Jake to be in Pittsburgh?
Yes.
Where do you wish he would go?
Cleveland.
Yeah. How do you feel about Jake being in Pittsburgh?
Awesome. I like seeing Jake.
Do you think he should visit the city more often?
Absolutely. I'm down for it.
Yeah.
Why? To Ohio is basically the message. Are you excited for Jake to be in Pittsburgh, and should he visit the city more often?
Yes and yes.
How long have you been a fan of Hoodie?
Ever since I was like a freshman in high school, I used to listen to his music.
Be a part of it, Hoodie, come on!
Hi, Hoodie.
I love the news.
Thanks. So hopefully, that gives you viewers out there an intake on Hoodie Allen and Jake Miller's music. I am personally a huge fan of the two. Make sure to check them both out while Lowdown goes on a commercial break. Lowdown will be right back.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Lowdown. For this episode, I had the chance to cover Firestone Theater's upcoming production, After the Blast, a play set in the wake of environmental disaster, where the human population has been forced to retreat underground. Let's hear what the people at Firestone had to say about After the Blast.
Well, Firestone Theater's been around as long as the school's been here, so that's 50-some years.
Firestone Theater's great because you get to kind of experience a segue into professional theater.
Any job that's in the theater a student can do, whether it's ushering or being an actor, stage managing, designing the lights, designing the audio, painting sets, yeah. We're all still students and we're all still learning, and we all just love theater, so we just kind of have a fun time as we're doing it.
We have 7 plays in our season this year. After the Blast is the second play of our season. After the Blast is this amazing play. It's set in a post-apocalyptic world where people live underground. People in the play are third generation. They have never seen the daylight, have never seen open sky. They've only lived underground in a highly controlled environment in society. The main characters are a man and a wife who are trying to have a baby, but they're being stymied in that attempt by the government.
Essentially, in the society that they live in underground, since there's been a nuclear apocalypse that's wiped out everything above the surface, they don't have infinite resources. So if you're going to have a child and you're going to have a human being that's going to consume more resources, you have to pass a test and they have to make sure you're going to be a good parent to this child. So that's why it's so strict.
Since the mother is diagnosed with depression, she keeps failing these tests. So her husband has found a robot that will help her with companionship and trying to cure her depression so she can pass this test.
I designed the robot that you'll see on stage in After the Blast. Originally, she's standoffish about the robot, but then it really does fill its purpose as a companion for her later on.
At first, I was all freaked out about acting with a robot, and once they brought Artie in, I got to see a lot of the process since I'm really good friends with the person, Ethan Cormie, who created the robot. I was worried about just not having some reactions to play off, but once they came in and he had those piercing blue eyes of his, it was just like I was talking to another person. And hearing the voice come out of the robot, it suddenly just clicked. Like, I felt like I was looking at my dog in a way. So I think it's really interesting how Anna bonds to this robot because she's so anti-simming. She's anti this whole new world she's seeing. But I think that there's somewhere in her heart that connects to this robot. And I think part of that has to do with where her and Oliver's relationship is in the moment. And I feel like this is the first thing she's had in her life in a long time that is listening to her without trying to fix her.
After the Blast is just a tremendous play. It has an awful lot to say about the human condition. So it's a play about where all of our realities have been stripped away, and so how do we remain human, and how do we make a connection and keep a connection with other humans when everything around us is totally artificial?
Usually when we do plays, they often reside in our time period or even far back, but this takes place in the future, and not only that, but the near future, which is why it's so important, because right now we live in a time where there's climate change and forests on fire, and the earth is screaming for help, and in this play, the earth has already screamed for help and died out, and I think that people really need to see what could happen to our world if we don't take care of it.
After the Blast is one of my favorite play scripts, so I can't wait to see Firestone Theater bring it to life. It looks like a play you won't want to miss. Lowdown will be right back. Welcome back to Lowdown, everyone. For this interview, I got to sit down with Thaddeus Gonzalez, a rock musician from Oakland, California. He performed at the Empire Concert Club and Bar. Let's take a look at what he had to say about his music.
Hey, my name is Thaddeus Gonzalez. I'm a singer-songwriter from Oakland, California. Depeche Mode is one of my biggest influences, and bands like Danzig, some punk bands, Morrissey, the Smiths, bands like that have kind of influenced me. And I think probably having a stronger frontman has always kind of been something that I've been into bands like that have a really strong frontman, The Doors, things like that. Singer-songwriters, like Drive-By Truckers, or a guy like Jason Isbell, Ryan Adams, people who can just pick up a guitar, acoustic guitar, and just play without having a lot of the circus around them. I enjoy that too. I tour a bit with an acoustic guitar. I think it's a good reflection of how strong an artist is if they can just do it by themselves without the smoke and mirrors. If I have a lyric or maybe a song title comes to my head, I'll immediately pick up my guitar and try to write music to it. But as far as actual lyrics, they just come and go all day long, weeks on end. Like I'm working on music right now, and I have all these lyrics that don't have any songs, which is the first time in a while and that I've had more lyrics than songs, than actual music. But I think it really, some songs happen very fast, and some songs just drag around for a long time. So my song Silver Inside from my last album, that was an old song that I showed my producer, and he said that, you know, we need to do that. So it got reworked to, you know, a more modern sound. So things stick around or they're brand new, it really depends. I think probably going through not feeling that good at certain points in life, in my life, that song was about knowing that there was, that I was gonna be rad, that there's something rad in people, that no matter what you're going through, that's really inside. And I think it was just a better way of saying you've got the good stuff inside. It's like you're silver inside. And I, that's all it is. It's just a way of feeling, knowing that you feel good in the inside and that your outsides are not that important. Like the song Surgeons is about people taking from you, acting like surgeons and trying to remove things from you that you want to hold on to. I think bands like Depeche Mode or The Doors or Danzig or these bands that have kind of a flip on a perception of songwriting, that's just a perception of people wanting to stay intact spiritually. And I say the surgeons, so I just, you know, I bring up the surgeons as someone taking from you, so then I write about the surgeons taking from you as if it's like a surgery, you know, but really it's not. It's just trying to protect your spirituality or whatever. I felt like there was not a lot of work going on in Electric Sister. Everyone was busy, and it felt like when you're in a band situation, you have to have all these different opinions about where this is gonna go. And I kind of knew exactly where I wanted to go, and I didn't need anybody else's opinion to tell me how to get there. So I said I was gonna just do this all myself. I was already writing songs. And so it was basically, I wanted to work more. I wanted to record more. I wanted to do more music videos. I wanted to be on the road more. And that wasn't happening with five other guys in a band. It just wasn't happening. It was like herding cats. In general, rock music should be drawn from different genres. And when it's not drawn from different genres, you don't get a different end result. And to me, right now, rock music's a little one-sided. It needs to be more dynamic, more character-driven, and less similar. It needs to be a little more abstract. I'm working on my third album. I've already started working on it, and I just cut a track in Berkeley, California, and I'm working with a different producer on the rest of, I have about 19 songs, and so we start working on those October 26th, so pretty soon, and that should be out probably March with the new album, so I'm pretty excited about it. Yeah, it's a lot of new music, and it's very different music in general. The genres are all different. I'm even going towards a little more garage rock, a little more acoustics, some trip hop. Just trying to get out of. I don't want to bore myself with hard rock. I love hard rock and it's in my blood, but I don't want to bore myself with it. Silver Inside to me is a very cohesive, strong album for what it is, and this next album is going to be different, and it's going to make me feel like I'm doing the right thing by doing something that's different than staying the same with the hard rock genre. But not that there's not going to be hard rock, but 19, 20 songs, you know, five of them are going to be hard rock, so it's going to be a little different, quite a bit different, which I'm pretty happy about. Thaddeus Gonzalez, follow me on YouTube, and thaddeusgonzalez.com. Has all my information for dates, and I tour quite a bit, and I'll probably be around wherever you are next year.
You don't want to miss what we have in store for the last part of this episode. Coming up next is someone we interviewed that was once on a popular TV show. Lowdown will be right back.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Lowdown. For this final package, we got to interview Tyler Hilton. Yes, Chris Keller from One Tree Hill. He performed live at the Oracle in North Canton and gave an amazing performance. Let's check it out.
I'm Tyler Hilton, and I'm a singer and an actor. I came on to promote my album in like 2004 maybe or something. So it initially was just to kind of come on, play a couple songs from the new record. My label had hooked me up with the gig, and then you know, that was going to be it. But I had so much fun doing it, and the character was so fun, and then the cast and I got so close that I just kept telling them, like, anytime you want to bring me back, I'm so down. And it just kept turning into like more and more of a thing. It was just supposed to be a real quick little thing. So I love playing Ohio, and so however this happened, I got booked here. The promoter's great. I've done a lot of shows for him, but my agent is usually the one that kind of like sets up these tours, and he always, you know, asks me if I like coming through a certain area. I love coming through Ohio. I haven't been through Canton in like 5 or 6 years, so I was stoked to see this come up. I really like interacting with the crowd and playing music for people. It's like, it's fun being in the studio, but I always find it a little more fun in the studio when I'm doing vocals if there's like people around. And I feel I miss that energy from being on stage. It's so scary and the stakes are so high, but I feel like there's just such a, I don't know, it's something so fun about it. It's like being on a roller coaster. I really like it. Songwriting is really important to me. You know, through jamming, sometimes when I like turn my brain off and I'm just playing guitar, piano, then these melodies or these music will kind of just come out, and I'll just kind of keep chasing down the stuff that I like, and it kind of forms into a song. But it's kind of like dreams or something. You know, like the lyrics definitely feel like dreams, where they don't really always make sense to me at first, but then when the song is done, it's like, wow. But yeah, I guess it's kind of like that. I got all this new music coming out, so I'm going to see how that goes. I'm working on some new stuff with some new people in Nashville, so we'll see how that kind of plays out. I usually have like a bunch of little things happening, and then we'll see what kind of wants to be born out of it. You know, like sometimes things just peter out and they're fun little adventures, but sometimes things want to go farther and they just do, and then I'm holding on at some point, you know? I've got like almost a whole record done that was pretty much gonna be this record, but I just didn't finish it in time. So it's probably like 8 to 10 songs ready to go for the next record. So as soon as I get back home, I'll start finishing that stuff up and getting ready for the next album. But this is one of those rare periods where I have a lot of new music like ready to come out. I'm like ready to go, which is cool because this year was really fun touring and promoting and stuff. And I'm excited to not like take a break. I'll take a break for like maybe, I don't know, 4 or 5 months, maybe 6 months, just to like finish everything up. But then I'll should be right back out on the road by next fall with a bunch of new stuff. Oh, I don't wanna be hurt by it anymore. And so that's all that's happening with the new music. With acting stuff, I got this really fun Christmas movie coming out Thanksgiving Day. And it's starring my wife, Megan Park, and this girl, Hillary Burton from One Tree Hill. And it's going to be on Lifetime Thanksgiving Day. So it's called A Christmas Wish. That's what it's called. Yeah, yeah. It'll be really fun. It's a really cute movie. Got a bunch of cool people in it. So that's what's next there. After tour's done, I'll start promoting that in New York. You know, it feels like for me, the music world is more directed by me. So, like, I can write if I want, I could sing if I want, I could play shows if I want. Acting's like a little different because you're kind of being given a script, and then you're kind of like have something to, it's almost like being a singer and being given a song. You're given something to say and then you kind of put your own vibe onto it. And it seems like it would be more fun to do the singing stuff because you're kind of more in control, but sometimes it's nice to kind of give over control of something and just be being able to be creative in like a really confined area. And that's what I feel like acting is. Like you're given parameters of like a situation, a character, a world, and then you can kind of like, you know, have some fun with jazz in between. With music, there are no parameters. Like the world, anything, I could do anything with anything. So it gets a little overwhelming, but also it's more freeing. So that's kind of like the main difference to me. I get tired of one and I do the other, but that's what I miss about both. When I'm doing acting, I miss the freedom of music. When I'm doing music, I kind of miss the constraints, the family atmosphere of being on a set and not being in charge. It's so nice to kind of just be in a group and have a group activity. Me, I'm like a solo artist, so I've always just been solo, you know, which is cool and not cool. So, you know, I can't get away from like roots music. That just seems to be like what's in my soul since I was a kid, and no matter what genre I'm doing, even if I'm trying to get away from something like that, it always ends up working its way back in. I don't know what that is. I don't know if it's some kind, like, it's just a weird situation that's just in me, but there's something in me that feels like an old man from the Depression. I don't know why. I don't know if that, and so all my music kind of uses a lot of elements that you can play on like a porch or like around a campfire. Mandolins, stomps, claps, guitars. Blues music is really big with me. Old country music, that kind of stuff is great. But I love, it's weird, but I love hip hop. I love indie rock. Like if I could have done things over again, sometimes like I wish I would have been in an alt rock band. Like there's something about that that's, but no matter what I do, it always has these like roots elements in it, because that's like where I'm from. Every once in a while, like I'll write something that's just kind of fun and it doesn't really mean a lot. It's just like a good time, but most of them mean a lot to me. But probably one called I Don't Want to Be Scared on the new record is like a really meaningful one. It's kind of about getting sober and just being like brave enough to like do something that like no one else you know is doing. Being brave enough to be like potentially lame for a second, you know, and not being the person that's like party animal. And just almost feel like it takes more courage to not be rock and roll when you're playing music, you know, which was hard for me. It's so fun. You have so many opportunities to party and have a blast. And that was one of those situations where I had to be like, well, what's best for me? What's best for my health and longevity? And how much do I like doing this? And do I want to do this forever? And I did, you know, so it's kind of, that was a good one for me. Yeah, if you want to follow me, you can follow me on, I'm Tyler Hilton on all the socials, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all that stuff. And then my tour dates will be on tylerhilton.com/tour. And the new record's called City on Fire.
Well, that's a wrap for this episode of Lowdown. Tune in next time for more great content.
Make sure to follow artists such as Tyler Hilton, Thaddeus Gonzalez, Jake Miller, and Hoodie Allen all on social media and give them a listen. Also be sure to keep up with Firestone Theater for news about future shows and performances.
Make sure to also follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and catch all of our episodes on our YouTube channel at ZTV Lowdown.
Thanks for tuning in. That's it for this episode on Lowdown.
This program was produced by ZTV at the University of Akron. Do you want to gain experience in video production, professional social media, or working with real clients? Visit the UA School of Communications online or follow us on social media to learn more. ZTV, make media, make a difference.